In this lecture, we discuss about some of the applications of the famous Hahn-Banach theorem. So, first theorem will be based upon the bounded linear functional. So, let X be a non-linear space and X not be any non-zero element in X. Then there exists a bounded linear functional f hat on X such that the norm of a f hat is equal to be 1 and norm and extension of the f of x naught is equal to be norm of x naught. So let x naught belongs to be a x and consider a subspace Z of a x consisting of all the elements x which can be written as a alpha times x naught, where alpha is a scalar and z is equal to be the subspace spanned by the x naught. So z, define a linear functional f by f of x is equal to be f of alpha x naught, where we define that f of x is equal to be alpha times norm of x naught. Here this f is bounded and has a norm 1, because if we consider the modulus of this f of x, this is equal to be modulus of f of alpha x naught, which is equal to be a modulus of alpha into norm of x naught, which is equal to be norm of alpha times x naught, which is equal to be norm of ax, because we have defined that x is equal to be alpha times x naught. So the norm of a f is equal to be supremum of modulus of a f of x over the norm of a x. And if we define over the supremum, this is less than equal to be 1, because the modulus of a f of x is equal to be norm of a x. So but the norm of a f is greater than equal to be modulus of a f of x over norm of a x, which is equal to be 1. So the norm of AF is equal to be 1. So hence, by the Hahn-Banach theorem in the norm space, we have the function has a bounded linear function extension f hash from z to x of the form norm of f hat is equal to be norm of AF is equal to be 1. Therefore, extension of the f at the point x naught is equal to be the function at x naught, which is equal to be norm of x naught, and hence the result. So the further is, let x be a norm linear space over a field k and x naught be any arbitrary member of ax and m naught be a arbitrary positive real number, then there exists a bounded linear functional f on ax such that the norm of af is equal to be m naught and f of x naught is equal to be norm of af into norm of ax naught. So let z be a span of x naught, which is equal to be t of x naught such that t belongs to be r. So clearly this is a subspace of ax. Now we define a phi on a z by phi of a t of a x naught is equal to be t times m naught norm of x naught. So it is easy to see that phi is a linear. Now for x belongs to be z, we have x is equal to be t of a x naught for some t. So we consider the norm modulus of a f of x naught, f of x, which is equal to be the modulus of f of t of x naught, because we consider the x is equal to be t x naught. So here the phi we have considered up as a t times the m naught into norm of x naught. So it is equal to be modulus of a t m naught into the norm of x naught, which is equal to be m naught into the modulus of a t into the norm of x naught, because here the m naught is a positive real. So this is equal to, by the definition of a norm, this is equal to be t times the norm of x naught, which is equal to be norm of ax. So modulus of f of x is equal to be m naught times the norm of ax. So clearly norm of f is equal to be m naught. So phi is a bounded linear functional on a z. So there exists a extension of f of this function over the x such that norm of f is equal to be norm of phi is equal to be m naught by the Harmonic theorem, and hence the norm of f is equal to be m naught, but f of x naught is equal to be m naught in norm of x naught. So for x naught belongs to be z, f of x naught is equal to be phi of x naught is equal to be m naught into norm of x naught, which is equal to be norm of f into norm of x naught, and hence the result. So further we have, let x be a non-trivial real linear space such that we can say that the x is a non-zero element. Then its first conjugate space, the first dual of this x, is also non-trivial. The first dual of x means that it's having a functional over the space x up here. So let x naught be non-zero, belongs to be x. So there exists a bounded linear functional f on ax such that f x naught is equal to be norm of ax naught, which is non-zero, and norm of f is equal to be 1. That is, f belongs to be a, the conjugate space is a non-zero bounded linear functional on a x, right? It means it is again a non-trivial. Hence we get the result. So for every x belongs to be a x, norm of ax is equal to be supremum of modulus of f of x over the norm of f, where f is a non-zero functional on a x. So you can find it non-zero bounded functional f naught belongs to be a the conjugate space of ax such that f of x is equal to be norm of ax and norm of f naught is equal to be 1. Now supremum of the modulus of f of x over norm of f is greater than equal to be modulus of f naught over the norm of f naught, which is equal to be norm of ax. Again, for a non-zero functional in a, lying in a dual space of ax, we have the modulus of f of x is less than equal to be norm of f into norm of ax. Therefore, the supremum of a modulus of f of x over the norm of f is less than equal to norm of ax. Hence, from these two inequalities, we can say that the norm of ax is equal to be the supremum of a modulus of f of x over norm of f, where the f is a non-zero functional on ax. So from this we can deduce this result. If f of x is equal to 0, for every f belongs to be a functional or dual space of ax, where f is a non-zero functional in a dual of ax, then x is equal to 0. So as x is a supremum of a modulus of f of x over norm of f, which is equal to 0, so you say that the x is equal to 0. So if for every f which is a non-zero functional on a dual space of ax and f of x is equal to be f of y, then x is equal to be y. So here f of x is equal to be f of y, so f of x minus y is equal to be 0 for every non-zero functional of the dual space of ax. So it implies that by the previous result that x is equal to be 0. So we have x minus y is equal to be 0, and hence x is equal to be y. So further we have, so let M be a closed subspace of a norm linear space ax and M is not equal to bx, and assume that U belongs to be a x minus M and D is represented as the distance between a point U and a set M, which is equal to be infimum of a U minus M, where M belongs to be a set M. Then there is a bounded linear functional f in a dual space of ax such that f of x is equal to be 0 for all x belongs to be M, f of U is equal to be 1, and norm of f is equal to be 1 by D, where 1 D is represented as a distance of the point U and a set M. Here this d is greater than 0 by the definition of this, So let N be a subspace of AX spanned by the M and U, spanned by the set M and the singleton set U is there. So every member of AN is of the form M plus TU, where small m belongs to be a capital M and T belongs to be a R. So define G on this N by G of M plus TU is equal to be T. Here G is a linear. Now G of M is equal to be 0 for some M belongs to be M, say. So we have a G of a U is equal to be 1. If I consider up a G of a U is equal to be 1. So for T is not 0, minus M by T belongs to be M, we have G of a M plus T U, which is equal to be the modulus of a T. And it can be written as a modulus of a T into norm of M plus TU over norm of M plus TU, which is equal to B. Now this modulus of a T will be rewritten as a, this, because T is a non-zero, and we common up this T from a bottom here, and we get the, or we can go with the here. This is a U minus of a minus M by T, and this T is moving inside. You can say by using up the property of a norm, or this moves outside. So here this is the U minus of a MT, where this M over T belongs to be M. So by the definition of this norm, we have a, this D is equal to be infimum of a norm of a U minus M. So you can say that this is less than by equal to be norm of a M plus T U over D. So let X is equal to be M plus T U belongs to be N. So norm of, so modulus of a G of AX, if I consider the X is equal to be M plus TU, is less than equal to be norm of AX by D, implying that G is a bounded. And norm of a G is less than equal to be 1 by D. So G belongs to be a N dash N prime, dual of AN. Again, D is the distance of a U comma M, which is going to be infimum of a U, norm of a U minus M. So there exists a sequence, say MN belongs to be M, such that U minus MN converges to be D. Now since G of a U minus MN is equal to be G of a U minus G of a MN, which is equal to be 1 minus of a 0, is equal to be 1 by the definition of a G of U. So we have 1 is equal to be G modulus of a G of a U minus MN less than equal to be norm of a G into norm of a U minus MN. So taking the n converges to be infinity, we have a 1 is less than equal to be norm of a G and this is equal to D. So we have 1 by D is less than equal to be norm of G. So hence from these two we get that the, from these two relations we get that the norm of a G is equal to be 1 by D. So there exists a bounded linear functional f in a dual space of ax, which is a extension of a g on a n, such that the f of x is equal to be gx for all x belongs to be n, and norm of af is equal to be norm of a g. Thus we have f of x is equal to be 0 for all x belongs to be n, f of u is equal to be 1, and norm of af is equal to be 1 by d. Hence we get the result. So now let M be a subspace of a nonlinear space X such that the M is not equal to be X, and assume that U belongs to be X minus M such that the distance D is equal to be norm of U minus M is greater than 0. Then there is a bounded linear functional F belongs to be a dual of AX or conjugate space of AX such that F of X is equal to be 0 for all X belongs to be M. F of u is equal to be d, and norm of af is equal to be 1. So here clearly this d is positive, and we can write n as a subspace of ax spanned by the m and u. So every member of n is of the form m plus t. So we can write the g on n by g of ax, which, and x can be considered as a m plus t u. is equal to be t into d. So here again the g is a linear, so now g of a m, if I consider that the x is equal to bm, here I consider only the m. So here the g of a m is equal to be 0 for some m belongs to bm, and g of a u is equal to be d, because here in this case we have considered the u part is 0 and here we consider the m part is 0. So for t is non-zero, minus of m by t belongs to bm, so we have a norm of m plus t u is equal to be the minus of a t into the minus of m by t minus of a u, which can be written as a modulus of a t into the norm of m minus m by t minus u, which is greater than or equal to be modulus of a t into d. So g of m plus t u modulus is equal to be the modulus of a t into d, which is less than or equal to be m plus t u. So let x is equal to be m plus t u belongs to be n. So modulus of a gx is less than or equal to be norm x, implying that g is a bounded and norm of a g is less than or equal to be 1. So g belongs to be a dual of n, and again we have a d is a distance of between the u and m, which is an infimum of u minus m. So let epsilon be greater than 0. And by the infimum property, there exists an element, say m belongs to be n, such that the norm of a u minus m is less than d plus epsilon. And choose v, which is equal to be m minus u over norm of m minus u, which is equal to be m over norm of m minus u minus u upon norm of m minus u. And now this belongs to be n. So here t is equal to be 1 over norm of m minus u, and m over norm of m minus u belongs to be n. So norm of a v is equal to be 1. So, but the modulus of a g of v is equal to be the d upon the norm of m minus u, which is greater than, by this property we use up, greater than d upon the d plus epsilon into norm of v. And as the norm of v is equal to be 1. So, as epsilon is greater than 0 is arbitrary, so modulus of a g of v is greater than equal to be norm of v, so norm of a g is greater than equal to be 1. Hence, we get from these two, here we get the norm of g is less than or equal to be 1. Here we get the norm of g is greater than or equal to be 1. So norm of g is equal to be 1. So there exists a bounded linear functional f in the conjugate space of Ax, which is an extension of g on n, such that f of x is equal to be gx, and norm of f is equal to be norm of g. Thus we get f of x is equal to be 0 for all x belongs to be n, f of u is equal to be d, and norm of f is equal to be 1. Now consider the following example out here. So let x be a r square, and we choose the x comma y belongs to be x, such that the norm of a x comma y is equal to be modulus of a x plus modulus of a y. You can easily check it out that this norm of a x y is a nonlinear space with this norm. You can check up the properties of nonlinear space. So take M as a set of x0, such that x belongs to be R, is a subspace of this x. And now we define M f from M to R by f of x comma 0 is equal to be x. You can easily prove that this f is a linear. So now the modulus of f of x comma 0 is equal to be modulus of x, which is equal to be norm of x comma 0. So norm of f is equal to be 1. So clearly f is a bounded. So f is a bounded linear functional on a M. So define f1 from x to R and f2 from x to R by f1 of xy is equal to be x plus y, and f2 of xy is equal to be x minus y for all xy belongs to be x. And again, it is easy to check it out. This f1 and f2 both are linear. So now I consider the modulus of f1 of xy, which is less than or equal to be, which is equal to be the modulus of x plus y, which is, we can say that less than or equal to be modulus of ax plus modulus of y. And this, by the definition of norm, is equal to be norm of x plus norm of x comma y. Similarly, f2xy is less than or equal to be norm of x comma y. So we found that f1 and f2 both are bounded, and norm of f1 is less than or equal to be 1, and norm of f2 is less than or equal to be 1. So that is, we can say that here norm of f1 is less than or equal to be norm of af, and norm of f2 is less than or equal to be norm of af. So now for all x and x comma 0 belongs to be m, f1 of x comma 0 is equal to be x, which is equal to be f of x comma 0, and f2 of x comma 0 is equal to be x, which is equal to be f of x comma 0. So it is very clear that the f1 and f2 are extensions of f. So further, for all x and 0 belongs to be m, we have f1 of x comma 0 is equal to be f of x 0. So modulus of x comma 0 is equal to be modulus of f1 x comma 0, which is less than or equal to be norm of f1 into norm of x comma 0. So norm of f is less than or equal to be norm of f1. Similarly, we get the norm of f is less than or equal to be norm of f2. So from these, we can clearly state that the norm of f1 is equal to be norm of f is equal to be norm of f2. So we get the results because in the previously we found that f1 is less than or equal to be norm of af and f2 is less than or equal to be norm of af. Now here we found that the norm of af is less than or equal to be norm of af1 and f norm of af is less than or equal to be norm of f2. So from these two we get they are same. Thank you.